जय गुरुदेव स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन दिस साइंस क्लास। सो वी वर डूइंग क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5, एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स। सो चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। आर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। अगेन आई एम स्टार्टिंग नंबरिंग फ्रॉम 1 बिकॉज ऑलरेडी यू हैव रिटन 8 क्वेश्चंस बिफोर दिस। And question number 1 is, what is an acid? Children, we have learnt about the acids, bases and salts, what are they? But here they ask about acid. And how you write the definition of acid? A substance dissolves in water to give hydrogen ions is called an acid. Means what is an acid? Any substance which when dissolve in water and after dissolving when they give hydrogen ions, then we can say that particular substance is an acid. They are sour in taste. You know, this is the first property of acid, that they are sour in taste. For example, oxalic acid and hydrochloric acid are the examples of acids. So children, here I have written 2 examples, oxalic acid and hydrochloric acid, because one example I have taken from acids which we obtain from plants, okay, plant products, and one example I have taken from the mineral acids. Means one example we can write here as a strongest acid, and one example of weak acid you should write here, okay. Any other example also you can write. You write here citric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, okay. So many acids we have learnt in this chapter. And in strongest acids, I have written hydrochloric acid here. You can write sulfuric acid also. You can give an example of nitric acid also. Okay. So next question number 2 is, what are strong and weak acids? Children, in one of the activity I have shown you in some of the class that we can detect the strong and weak acids also, whether the acid is strong or weak, with the help of pH paper. Okay, I have shown you pH paper also. So first of all, definition of strong acid is acids that dissolve in water to give a large number of hydrogen ions are called strong acids. Means the acids which gives large number of hydrogen ions, that are called strong acids. Example here, same means any mineral acid example you can give. Mineral acids are sulfuric acid, nitric acids, and hydrochloric acid. Okay, any 2 name you should write here. So what are the strong acids? Those acids are called strong which gives us large number of hydrogen ions when they dissolve in water. Okay, and after this, weak acids. What are the weak acids? Acids dissolve in water to give a small number of hydrogen ions. Means this definition you can write down just opposite to the strong acids. Means they give large number of hydrogen ions when dissolve in water, and if weak acids when we dissolve in water, they give small number of hydrogen ions. Okay, so examples are weak acids, All naturally occurring acids are weak acids. For examples, means weak or mild, we can say two words we can use for them. Examples are organic acids. Children, organic acids, I have given you in one of the question also, what are the organic acids? Means under organic acids, you can give example of citric acid. Okay. Citric acid, or you can write here tartaric acid. Tartaric acid, or oxalic acid, or malic acid, any acid you can write here. Okay, so any organic acid is called weak acid because they give small number of hydrogen ions when we dissolve in water. Question number 3 is, what are dilute and concentrated acids? Children, acids on the basis of their concentration, means concentration of acid, how much amount of acid is present in that, according to that we can classify the acids into two category, means dilute or concentrated. Acids that contain very little or no amount of water is called concentrated acid. Means when very less amount of water is there, or there is no nothing water, or no water is present in any of the acid, then we can say that acid is concentrated acid. Means very thick acid. And dilute acid is acids that contain a large amount of water are called dilute acids. Means any acid, if there is a less quantity of acid and more quantity of water is there, then we can say that is dilute acid. Okay, so on the basis of their thickness, we can classify acids into two categories. So next question is question number 4. List the properties, physical and chemical properties of acids. So children, first property is acids are sour in taste. This you know already. Acids have corrosive action on skin. Or cloths also you can write here, skin and cloths. Okay, so acids cause painful blisters. Means this second point meaning is that acids are corrosive in nature, or acids have corrosive action on skin and clothes. Means when a drop of acid fall on our skin or cloth or any other object, they can readily burn them or spoil them. Understand? That is called corrosive. And acids can cause painful blisters. Means when acid fall on our skin, they can cause painful blisters. Means bahut painful ghav kar dete hain, aapke skin mein fafole ban jate hain. Okay, so acids are soluble in water. All the acids are soluble in water, that's why we can make dilute acid. So acids conduct heat. Okay, so all the acids can conduct heat also. And here all the points you can give number also to them. Means this is first, this is second, third, fourth and fifth. In this way, if you write numbering, it can help you to learn. Okay. So, next question number 5 is, what are bases? List the physical and chemical properties of bases. So, children, in the same way, what are the acids, and similarly, here they ask about the bases. Bases or basic substances are bitter in taste and are soapy to touch. Means, what are the bases? If any substance is bitter in taste or soapy in touch, then it can called as base. So, bases are also compounds. As you know that all they are compounds. Like we can say sodium hydroxide, this is also a compound. Sodium ammonium hydroxide, it is also a compound. These all are bases. Okay. So, let's see the properties now. Properties of bases. First point is, bases are bitter in taste. Okay. Second is, same as acids. Bases are corrosive and cause painful blisters. Here you can make separate points also. In acid case, we had made separate points. But here we have written in single, under the single point. So they are corrosive in nature and cause painful blisters. Okay. And third point is, bases react with the oil present in the skin to form soap. Okay. Here by mistake it is written soap. It is not soap. Actually it is foam. F-O-A-M. Foam. Means, children, when we apply soap on our skin, then what will happen? It will form foam. Foam means jhag. Okay. And how this foam will form? Because when we apply any soap on our skin, it acts on the oil present in our skin. Present on our skin. And this oil also has some dust or dirt particles. So along with this oil particles, dirt or dust also come out from our skin along with this foam. Understand? So these are the main properties of bases. Next is question number 6. What are strong and weak alkalis? We have learnt about the acids. What are the strong acids and what are the strong weak acids? So here they ask about the weak alkalis and strong alkalis. Means alkalis are bases, you know. That they ask about the bases here. So first one is strong alkalis. Produces more number of hydroxyl ions. Children, these hydroxyl spelling is a little bit wrong here, so make correct. If any of the substance produce more number of hydroxyl ions, they are called strong alkalis or strong bases. What are the hydroxyl ions? Hydroxyl ions, in bracket you can write OH. Okay, in the same way we have seen in case of acids also. If acids are strong, they release H positive ions or hydrogen ions. So many hydrogen ions or more hydrogen ions, and here you can write negative sign. OH negative, this is called hydroxyline. Okay, if positive or negative charge is there, then only we can say any of the object, any of the substance is ion. Okay, so this is strong alkalis, means strong alkalis always produce large number of hydroxyl ions. So that's why they are called strong alkalis. And example, you can write down NaOH, means sodium hydroxide. And weak alkalis, in the same way, just opposite to this, you can write when bases dissolve in water and produce less number of hydroxyl ions are called weak alkalis. Okay, and their example is NH4OH, means ammonium hydroxide. Okay children, so it's if weak alkalis are there, then they always produce less hydroxyl ions, means less number of OH negative ions in water. Okay, so after this, next question is question number 7, that is name two acids and two bases. Two acids are sulfuric acid, nitric acid, or you can write name any two names of your choice. I have given you so many names of acids. And two bases name, just now we have studied sodium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide. You can write two names here also. And children, after this we will discuss about the next question answers in the next video.